As you start building your Appian application, one of the first things you'll need to do is add and manage users. What's the best way to set up your users for success? And how can you manage your users effectively? Let's look at some common ways to ensure your users are set up correctly within Appian. First, it's important to distinguish between basic users and system administrators. Basic users can access and create application objects based on the permissions they've been assigned, whether directly or as part of a group. System administrators have additional privileges, like the ability to access all tools and capabilities in Appian, determine user roles, and create other users. To create a user, you must be a system administrator. Create your users from the Admin Console. From the menu, select Admin Console, and then choose Users under Authentication. Click Create. Enter a unique username, as well as the user's first and last name. Enter the user's email address. Fill out any additional information, and select whether this user should be a system administrator. All users must sign in for the first time with a temporary password. If you do not create a password here, the system will create one for you and email it to your new user. If you choose to create your own temporary password, you are responsible for providing that password to your users. Click Create, or Create and Add Another to add more users. Once you add your users, you can easily update and refine their information or permissions as needed. Basic users are always able to modify their own profile information. System administrators can prevent basic users from editing others' profiles, but not their own profile. You can view and update users from the Admin Console under Users. Click a user to see the update dialog. Additionally, you can use the Users view of Appian Designer. Note that users are not objects, so they will not appear in any other Appian Designer list, except in this area. If a user is locked out after too many failed password entry attempts, system administrators can unlock them from the Admin Console. Follow the steps for updating a user, then click the banner message to unlock the user. System administrators can deactivate and reactivate user accounts to temporarily revoke system access for certain users. For example, let's say Dan Designer takes a temporary position on another team within your company. He does not need access to your application now, but when he returns, he will resume his responsibilities on the team. You can deactivate him temporarily to preserve his data in the application. To deactivate, go to the Admin Console, select the user, and choose Deactivate. You can then return to this menu and select Reactivate when Dan returns to the team. Finally, let's touch on security. Users with administrator permissions for a specific application or object can change users' access to that object. System administrators can also change individual permissions for any object or application. However, Appian best practice is to always set security at the group level. To access applications or objects, basic users should be added to a group with assigned permissions for those applications or objects, rather than given permissions individually. Creating a group is simple. You can do this from the Appian Designer build view. Click New and then Group. Once you've created a group and set its security permissions, you can add members to the group. One way is to choose Add Members and search for the user you'd like to add to this group. But a more efficient way to add users to groups is by configuring automatic membership rules that match users to groups based on specific criteria. To learn more about working with users in Appian, visit us at Academy Online. You can also get a free Appian Community Edition environment to try it out yourself. Thank you for watching, and happy learning!